Welcome back, everybody. I am APH, and well, we are in cycle 30, and wow, did they ever make some progress in closing this area up. Now, I gotta say, it's coming along quite good, and well, we're in the early days to kind of give them a chance to just get this area closed up. Let's just kind of take a quick tour. I gotta say that the Seaside Bistro right here with the extra rooftop terraces looks really nice. The tributes, the monuments up top are now done, and we've got some areas for opportunities over here. It looks really interesting with the roofs and with the shrubs. I think it came along really good. I think we're ready to start sending metal over here, as that's kind of something that we'll be covering. I think there's some room over here too that we can add some rooftop terraces in this episode. So we'll be getting along to that shortly here. This area right here looks so amazing that I just keep coming back to it. Now, yes, it's all done. It looks amazing. And up here, all of these water wheels are done, and that's good. That's amazing. We're ready kind of for the next step, maybe to place some more down in here and maybe some more down in here. You can see the water is very low, and you can see that I've knocked out some of this area over here. That's going to keep going away. And that brings us over to over here. Now over here, you can see that I went ahead and went with a stack of the industrial log piles with a curved staircase. They can't get all the way, well, they can get to the bottom, but they red line somewhere right around that one that has logs in it. So they can't place anything in any of the rest, but they can do some building over here. I do want to get a forester over here in this episode and get some lumberjack flags kind of in this area, maybe some houses over here, getting ready for breaking this off into its own area. And we need to get some berries over here, but I'm not sure if we have enough red line to make it happen. And that brings us over to here. This area turned out good with the rooftop terrace surrounded by the shrubs. I think deciding not to go with the tribute there was the good decision, but I think that we've got some opportunity kind of in this gray area right here to kind of do some building. And that brings us back to over here in this corner. Now, I had to do a little bit of finagling to make this come together. I had to move the district building over here in order to get enough red line in order to kind of make that happen. And if we follow it around, you can see it red lines right here. So we're not going to be able to build too much further on this side over here without breaking away another district. Now, that kind of gets us going here. Taking a look at the water source, this right here, we've got more than four spaces worth of water flowing down. And so this path right here may have been a little too aggressive to think that we could only get away with four here. So I do want to widen this up, and I'm thinking that we widen it up by maybe that many, and then we replace this with some one highs across here. And as for the rest of this, I do want to raise this up higher. And I think they can get to this corner now that it's kind of in the neighborhood of where we want it. So let's go ahead and get rid of this up to that spot there. Let's get rid of our pathway here. We got to be very careful not to get rid of other things, and we'll just kindly get rid of our path here. And I'm gonna build this area up real quick as I ask you guys a question. We have been running the series for close to a month, and viewership on the series is starting to dwindle as a result. So I'm kind of curious, what would you guys like to see on the channel next? As we're getting to that point where I have to kind of make a decision for the growth of the channel of what to play next to kind of bring it together. I've got some ideas. Surviving the Aftermath officially released today. So Surviving the Aftermath would be an idea. Against the Storm would be another good suggestion that I think it's a roguelike city builder where we could make an episode roughly last about 30 minutes and then it could kind of go from there. As well as Satisfactory just did a huge update, and Satisfactory's pretty big in the building community. It would show a little bit more of my industrial side. We do need some farms in here as kind of an offset, so I'll be placing those real quick. So those are some of the games that I've looked at. I've also looked at a space game, something along the lines of maybe, Space Haven, or a game like RimWorld. Those would be some good options. They are Billions might be a good option. That's kind of a good roguelike, or something like FTL, where we could make episodes that are roughly within the 30 minutes kind of window that you guys are looking for, 20 to 30 minute window, where they are edited to kind of make it that enjoyable situation. So I need some feedback from you guys, absolutely, of what you guys are looking for kind of in the future. We want a water pump here. just to kind of gather some water, because we will be breaking apart a district on this side. Let's get some carrots kind of in here. Since this area is nice and green, we'll just go like right up to, probably up to there, and then we'll break apart the district here, and in the future we'll break it apart here, letting them kind of run this this row as far as they can run it for the time being. We'll at least get it to a good point. Something that I also noticed, and I want the beavers to clear out, is this is too high. It needs to be down a little bit. So I'm going to drop it down by 2. At some point in time during this cycle, we'll be placing some gates in there, but that's the height that it should have been. This is part of why water never flowed through that in the last cycle. We're probably ready to unpause these, and we're ready for a grist mill over here. So let's go ahead and start planning out that grist mill just to kind of get it going. We'll go ahead and bring this up like this, and we're going to need some storage underneath this to kind of make this happen. So we're going to place small warehouse there, a small warehouse there. The grist mill, this power line is going to the carousel, and it's not currently powering the carousel, so I'm going to go ahead and break it now and go ahead and put a T connector in there. So we'll just do something like that. And then as for this spot, we just need the bakery, it faces that way, which is perfectly fine, and the grist mill faces that way. So we'll get the power coming in this way. Let's pause the small warehouses. I want to build this off camera so I can configure it as I kind of build it, but we'll get it all planned out. So we'll go something like that, and we'll place our walkway up like this, and then we'll place a walkway up like that. We'll just not there, just right there and right here, connect that so it's all good. So we're just going to build something like that. I do have 7 unemployed beavers over here and 11 homeless. We can probably pause one of these for the time being, and we'll need to look at housing kind of a little bit further over here. So let's go ahead with expanding out this housing a little bit. So we'll go just 2 more. Yeah, we'll go 2 more. We'll go like this, and that will allow us to place houses here. In the future, this is going to be its own district. So I guess houses now is not really like a bad thing, as eventually I'll be breaking this into its own district just for this area up here, and that would put all those people back in this area of Ren when that happens. So that will take care of food. We'll get our bread over here, and we're going to raise our comfort level up a little bit. I think that bread is going to be all of the well-being points we're going to go after in this episode for this area, but that brings us over here. Now, taking a quick look at the well-being over here, we're at 13. This is phenomenal. Campfires is the lowest, in beaver statues is none, and then getting the carousel going will be a thing. So I think to help with campfires, we're going to place some love in this area right here. So we're just going to clear out a little bit here, something about like that, and then we're going to place some dynamite up in here to bring this area down. So something just like this. Let's get that over there, and then this area down here, let's go ahead and knock it down as well. Let's get that little end piece, and we'll get this up to here. So we're going to have to remove that tree to make this all happen. So let's just mark that up now. Yeah, so we'll bring this down, and we're going to place some fireplaces in there. That'll help bring this area together. We'll get metal piped over, because I don't think it's being piped over yet. But we have metal. Something I forgot to show, I'm pretty sure, is that our platform is completed. So we're ready for that. And onto this area, we take a look. We're a solid 13. Again, campfire and rooftop terrace is the big thing. Roofs are a little low. Books are starting to climb up there, which is good. We can add a lot of rooftop terraces where we removed the lumber mills in the last one. So let's do that. Let's get some rooftop terraces there. We'll place one there, and we'll place one here. And then this area, I don't think I can place one because of the way that it's configured there. That brings us over to here. We've got some opportunities here. Let's go ahead and clear out the planting area here, and we'll go ahead and drop a walkway down. This is going to be a little bit tricky because we have to remove these dams in order to make this happen. And maybe what we'll do is during the current season, maybe we'll remove up to there, and we'll replace those with the levees now. And once those are replaced and we've got our path reestablished here, then I'll remove these couple here and get those replaced with levees so that this area can dry out a little bit. We might have to do something with like a water dump over here just to maintain it, if it's not maintained by the water that's in the aqueduct itself. But I think that will kind of take care of that. Do we have enough foresters nearby to get these trees? And the answer is absolutely. I'd like one more forester over here, but it's probably a kind of low priority, as they'll get that. And then once they get it, because it's no longer set as a planting zone, it should clear out itself. So we'll come back and visit this in the future once this has kind of had a chance to, you know, close up the levees and I've had a chance to replace those. And then we'll fill in some campfires in there. That brings us to up here. We're going to do something a little bit. I told you guys I wanted to add some storage, and I think I figured out a decent way of adding storage. So let's get rid of the pathways only. We'll go up past the gate there. We're going to need to fill in this section, and I believe we start with our two highs in here. So we'll just, we'll bring it like right over to there. We're going to go ahead and bring this over, and we'll just bring that over. That'll bring us up to our kind of mark there. And so in the last episode, our planks were just an absolute happy dance, getting down into the less than 100 at one point in time. And then all we did was build with lumber after that, and they bounced back to close to 3,200 planks. Absolutely astronomical. Our gears are finally climbing up to that 650 mark. They're looking good. So that's recovered. It's one of those yes please things. Now we've got our food. I'd like to get that a little bit under control. So with that, let's get a large warehouse facing that way. We'll place one this way and this way. And for getting across it, let's get a pathway right here in the center. We'll place a pathway this way so that they can get up on top. And then we're going to pipe power this way right here. And I don't know quite yet, but we might path power this way too, leaving the walkways in the middle. But for right now, I just want to have them build this, as that's going to be pretty important. And then I'll reconnect the paths afterwards. We're going to do the same thing on this side, where the path is going to be out by one so that we can connect it when we're ready. But yeah, that I think that's going to look good like that. It will kind of tie into the whole theme. That brings us over to over here. Let's start down here where this is done and we're ready to place our carousel. So let's go ahead and drop that bad boy in place so they can get building it. I believe we need a path to kind of connect it. And let me know about this right here, if you guys would like to see a second carousel up there, or if you'd like to see the other tribute. We don't have one of the tributes yet, so it would be the first one, but that would kind of be the distributing factor there. But that brings us over here. Now, this is going to be a little bit trickier because we have some power lines here. So we're going to have to do this as a two-part thing. Let's get rid of our roads first, I guess. That would be the starting. Let's get rid of those paths. And half of this will go to one district, half will go to the other district. So we're just going to go with some large warehouses, something like that and like that. Looks like the spacing is off by one, but we'll just make that do. And for the power itself, we're going to have to get power over to here in order to kind of make this work. And then once it's piped over to there, we're going to have to come back this way and reconnect it. So let's place some one highs, something like this. This is going to be temporary. It's going to come back out. And then we're going to, this spot right here will be this upper middle part in the future. And we're just going to place a T connector there on both sides, something like that. And we'll just place our L brackets on the edge here. And then we should be able to connect this up. And then in the future, we'll just have to get rid of this in order to build the other half. But at least it should get power kind of connected there. And then we'll do these kind of in a moment of everything else is ready, we'll just connect them. And that brings us over to here. This area looks good. I think we're ready to start expanding out our water canals here. And this is something I completely forgot about. Let's fix this one and this one. It looks like we need a one high, and it's going to, if anybody's OCD, I'm sorry, as that's going to probably drive some people nuts. Let's go ahead and drop our water wheel in there. And something that I noticed in editing is this is supposed to be a T connector, and I apparently left it as a straight pipe, but that's okay. It should get relatively fixed quickly, as I don't think that this is going to take a whole lot of work to get this done. I could be wrong, but I don't think it's going to be a whole lot of work to get that done. And then that will kind of alleviate them to be able to maybe expand a little bit. And maybe we expand this way so we can connect this set of power wheels with this set of power wheels. So we'll go, I think it's too high. So we're just going to do, let's grab the too high. Let's start dropping them in here. and we'll just go up to that corner, and then we'll bring it up the rest of the way that we need. I think from here, I think it's a 3 high. Gets us to where we want to be, and then we'll place some just our power wheels in here once that's built, and then we'll connect up our power. I think that will look nice. I'll let them build this before we revisit that. We're day 3, and I want to keep an eye on the water because I think we can have some issues with some flooding if we're not careful. That brings us over here. Now, if we click on the distribution center, you can see that we've got a red line right around here, and we've got a red line right around here. That's a bummer because I wanted to get a forester over here. The good news is they can build the forester. They just can't operate the forester, but we're going to get a forester there. We'll need a forester down here somewhere, but for the moment, I just want to put down the lumberjack flags, and it's already marked. I'm going to be marking trees to harvest off camera as it causes so much lag being in that unoptimized screen. So we'll let them start building that, and then we have some room over here where we're going to need our houses. So let's start placing those, and we're just going to build this section up, and then we're going to place the houses. It might be the second half of this cycle before we break this apart. And as for the edge here, I expanded it out 1 just so I would remember to do this. And we want to bring it, my guess would be up to about there. So we're going to kind of, let's place in 4 so I kind of get a guideline here. And we're just going to connect it there to make sure that, yeah, that's 4. And we're just going to build up the next section kind of. So I want them to build this. I only want them to build the aqueduct side at first, not the power wall side, as expanding out the water is more important. All right, so yeah, that's what we're going to expand it out to be. It's not huge, but I think it's going to take a good chunk of the time. What we might do to help with that time is just place a tester here where we place a walkway on the one side, and we see if a walkway on the one side helps out a lot. And if it does, what we'll be doing is in the future we'll be placing these walkways wherever we build. So we're just going to do a little experiment and see if they build this side quicker than this side. In theory, this is less voxels on this side, so in theory they should build this side quicker, but we'll kind of do that test and kind of see which one builds quicker. I have a lot of faith that they can make it to the end here before it redlines. What I don't have a lot of faith is this is a very tall tower. How long it might take them to build that is a little bit beyond me. Let's clean up this section right there. And that brings us over here. Now, I've been kind of slowly checking the areas, kind of seeing what they look like. Again, we're a solid 13 over here. Campfires and rooftop terraces is the smallest thing on our list. And I'm a little bit surprised that the rooftop terraces with these are that low. But for campfires, we can absolutely give them some love. Let's go ahead and drop a staircase down here. We'll prioritize this up so it kind of gets built a little bit quicker. And then in this area down here, we'll place some campfires. So we'll start like in the corner here and just do something like that. We'll bring our road across on the inside there. And then over here, just to help with this, let's go ahead and drop a stick of dynamite right there so we can place a water dump over here. And I do want them to build this relatively quickly, so I'm going to go ahead and prioritize that up. And I'm a little worried about beavers doing silly things in this area if we don't place a stopper here in the future. So I'm going to let them build this, then I'm going to place a high power pass here so we can start our power connectors. And this walkway will give them the opportunity to work from the bottom, but I want to kind of have that kind of going before we do anything. And that brings us back to over here and just to kind of see how they're doing. Now they've got this walkway right here. That's good. They've got the farmhouse already planted. We don't have berries for what this district will become, and I haven't quite figured out where I want to place them. This is going to be tricky because we could bring a walkway this way because it doesn't look like they're getting through all the potatoes. We could place some berries up there. That could be a thought. They are building this. That's really nice, and this is starting to fill up. That's really good. Hopefully we get a chance to see this being full. I guess what we could do, this area will be controlling this mountaintop. We could place a water dump up on the top of there and place berries up there. Maybe knock it down one level just to kind of bring it down to this height and do that. That's something I'm going to have to think about. That's a lot of effort for berries when we're going to have a district over here as well. Let's get our forester over here. So just let's try that again. Let's get that. And since we already know we're going to need berries for this district too, let's start with the berries over here, and we'll go with something that looks about like this. I do want them using this walkway as their primary source of moving around, so I don't think I need a path this way, and maybe a little too many berries. Let's plan on this right here being maples, and I think that that will kind of draw everything together good. And then what we'll do is we're going to figure out how high this platform is, and that's what we're going to build on the water over here for our housing community. So that's going to be a little bit of time for them to kind of draw everything together and kind of make that look good. Let's take a look and see if our projects are coming together. It looks like they're getting ready to start on this, which is pretty good. They've already filled in the majority of the underworks, which is amazing. And over here, they get the platforms. They did. So we've got our rooftop terraces, and it looks like we're a solid 14 now. And it looks like campfires is the lowest now. And the books are continuing to go up. That tells me we might have more books than what I thought. So we're going to have to figure out a place for campfires up here. Maybe this row right here. Not quite sure. Or, well, we definitely want to do the campfires in here, but that means we got to close this up. The power is only going to the carousel. So we're okay to remove this right here for now. And I think we only have to remove that one. I could leave that one as a dam. Let's get rid of that. And we just saw our beavers walk on water. Oh, this might be a little trickier. Okay, let's get rid of that. I did not realize that this was also open here. So that's a little bit problematic. All right, let's get rid of, let's try that again. Get rid of those, and we'll bring our levees kind of over this way, and then we'll replace that. Something like that. And once they build that, then I can place that builder back. There's beavers down here. Oh, they're chopping down the trees, that's perfectly fine. Let's prioritize this up so they get it going. That way I can place that builder back. Probably just lost a lot of my building capacity as this area. What do we have for builders over here? We only have 4. Wow. I don't know where I could place another builder that isn't kind of off kilter. I guess we could place one here, and then we could face it that way. We could probably place 2 of them here. That would probably work and help in the future. I like that 16 mark for builders, and this would get us up to 8. This would get us up to 12, and this one right here would get us up to 16. So yeah, we'll go with that. That kind of brings this area together looking really good. And I think that this is kind of a good solid start for the season. I was hoping that we would make it into the drought, but I just realized that we were running on 1x instead of 2. So we might do a little cut just to where the drought starts, to kind of take a look and see what we're looking at for the drought itself, how many days and all that good jazz before we wrap things up. So we'll be back in just a second. All right, so I'm bringing you guys back just before the drought starts to show you something. We've got all of our water wheels are going in right now. We're up to a little over 7,600 horsepower. If we come around to this side over here, this is not connected, but this is another 1,400, and this also is not connected, and this is not going. Oh, that's a bummer. I'm not sure why those ones are not going, but 1980. But as you can see, water's pouring out this end down here, which looks amazing. So we're going to have to do some things to connect up all of that water together. As for this corner, I did place in the floodgates and kind of did some regulation because, well, we had a little bit of a flooding situation, so I've got to regulate it just a little bit. And they're plugging away at this construction project. They're getting close to this corner, which is kind of where they left off. And as for the bread production, yes please, we're finally starting to turn some flour. It's very, very, very nice that we're getting some flour, and I think they're ready to start getting some bread over here. So our food will kind of get expanded out, and that will look a little bit better. And kind of right now, we're about to roll over to the next day, and we're going to see what the drought is, and that will kind of wrap up the episode. So 22 days, not bad, not bad. So a 30-day cycle, so we'll come back around day 15. I'd like to thank you guys for joining in, and we will see you in the next episode.